morning, afternoon. Welcome back to our channel. I saw a picture of Black Linn, which is a waterfall down our local glen on Facebook this morning, so I just thought I'd come and have a wee look for myself. So I'm going to walk down to there. I'm also trying out this Garmin Etrex 10 that I was given. I created a route on Viewranger and I've downloaded it on here, so I'm going to give it a go. Hope you enjoy the wee video. I've got coffee with me and stuff, so I'll have a wee break when I get down there. It's about 10 degrees today. It was up at 20 yesterday, so quite a drop today. And it's been raining quite heavily during the night, so maybe a bit muddy. Anyway. Cheers. I think that this route is the one I plotted, and that's where I am just now, which is a heading kind of, heading kind of that direction. Which I think is much the way I planned it. So obviously not really used to this thing, but see how it goes. I think these are the waypoints that's plotted. I'm going to go back and have a look at the compass, because the compass should show me my heading. Yeah. Compass seems to show me the heading that I should be going in. Found the remains of some sort of den. It's obviously, well, it collapsed in on itself. I think the river along that line there. So I'm going to go down here and hopefully the falls will be further along there. And I got down to the river, I had to cross the deer fence. There's a track over the other side, but I want to do things more adventurously. I met a girl walking her dogs and she said that Black Linn's the next waterfall down, so hopefully I'll get there along here. Looks a bit steep down there, so I'm going to continue up this way, around the top. Can't remember the name of this waterfall, but I'll stick it in the description when I locate it. Couple of huge cave-like areas, a big overhang there. Lots of garlic down here. So I'm here at Black Linn Falls. I've got my coffee, I've got a pork pie, I've got some chocolate, and a bit Here. I'm also trying out these trousers, which are supposed to be waterproof. They seem to have done so far okay. So I think if you kneel down in them, you will get a wet knee. But they seem to be waterproof in so much as just walking through long grass and stuff will still keep you dry. Maybe just showerproof is more to the point, more accurate. So, put in my coffee, then sit down, cool myself down a bit before I head up the road. I'm going to walk another kind of half a kilometre that way, and then back up to the road and back along Calder Side Road. Here's just a wee quick comparison of the Etrex 10, which is obviously an old device. It's not got colour screen and you really don't get much information on it at all. With my mobile phone. So this is the Viewranger app on my mobile phone with the plot of the route that I plotted out on the computer. Obviously you can see there's a much more detail in Viewranger. Even down to the elevation map. This does have a compass on it, however, which can show your heading and shows obviously sunset, sunrise, your GPS location, all that kind of stuff. My phone doesn't have a compass function on it at all. I just thought I'd do this comparison as well. This seems to be saying my heading is south though. Well, southwest. It actually should be northeast. It's a bit weird. Obviously I'm facing north just now. It says my heading is south, but my heading is not south because I'm going up this way. You can change the data fields along the top of the screen to anything you want. Elevation, 152 metres, bearing northeast, which is correct. It was saying south a minute ago, and the little pointer arrow seems to be pointing south. Yeah, I'm not very convinced of this thing. Perhaps I should just learn proper navigation with maps and my compass. Anyway, nearly had my coffee and my chocolate. It's about 20 past one. I need to be home by about 2:30. So, I'm going to finish my coffee and then wander further along. See you in a bit. Next time anybody's coming down here, bring a plastic bag. Take away some of the rubbish, please. Still recording. Right. There's two bags of rubbish in about 5 minutes. Maybe 10 minutes. Place looks a bit tidier just now. I can't really take any more. Back, you can see there's Budweiser cans over the other side. Well, a couple of things, somebody's shoe and a couple of bags. I'll get more next time I'm down. And there's a bundle of stuff down that side as well. And over there. Just tidy up, you lazy buggers. It's lighter when you're taking it out than it is when you're bringing it in. Anyway, enough of a rant. See you later. I'm just following the game trail. However, I may come across a problem. Obviously the little animals can get through this. I don't think I can. Not without hands and knees crawling, so I'm gonna have to go up around, I think. It'll be fun. Yeah, well, doing this while on slippy mud while holding the camera. It's not the easiest. It's quite steep. And carrying two bags of rubbish, of course. Can I make that tree? Yeah. I think that must have happened recently. Another wee trail along here. Anyway, so I've come to what I think is Hart's Burn, beside Hermit's Glen. But it's a pretty steep trench, and then quite steep to get up the other side. And I really should be recording my route down that way. I was diverted because of that tree. So given it's now 13:50 and I need to be back by 2:30, I think I'm going to have to cut it short and go down this way. Follow the route of the stream back up through the fields there. Anyway, so hope you've enjoyed this wee trek. I'll do it again sometime. Thanks for joining me. See you again. Ta-ra. Bye.